हैं अनुज दयाल. मिस्टर अनुज दयाल इज द एग्जीक्यूटिव डायरेक्टर कॉरपोरेट कम्युनिकेशंस इन दिल्ली मेट्रो रेल कॉरपोरेशन. ही ऑल्सो सर्व्स एज द ऑफिशियल स्पोक्सपर्सन ऑफ DMRC. मिस्टर दयाल हैज हेल्प्ड दिल्ली मेट्रो इन सस्टेनिंग इट्स इमेज एज अ टॉप बॉडी इन द ट्रांसपोर्टेशन सेक्टर नॉट ओनली इन इंडिया बट इन एशिया एज वेल. आई वुड लाइक हिम टू कम हियर, शेयर हिज व्यूज एंड एनलाइटन अस.
Good morning to everyone, dignitaries on the dais, Shri Mule, Shri Dilip Rath, Mrs. Anuradha Maul and Shri Jinpal Singh, ladies, gentlemen, students. My association with Abdul Kalam ji has been, when I was a child, I was in class 7, the first Indian satellite Aryabhatta was launched. And the Aryabhatta site, you all know that, no? Aryabhatta? So that Aryabhatta satellite, I had the good fortune of touching it. Incidentally, because my father was in the army and he was responsible for the quality control, the electronic quality control of Aryabhatta. He was an engineer. And he worked very closely with Dr. U.R. Rao, who was from ISRO. And Dr. Kalam at that time was a very, also from the same organization. So that is some association I have with the space world and Dr. Kalam. Two other associations with Dr. Kalam which I have. When he settled in Delhi, before that he was looking for a place in the south on the foothills of Nilgiri Hills. So I happened to go there to study a community radio system and they showed me the place where he might have settled. And another association was when he came to the Delhi Metro to give all of us a talk. And I had taken out a book on the management strategies of Delhi Metro. Srijan was kind enough to arrange a meeting for me with Dr. Kalam and I presented a copy. So these are my associations with Dr. Kalam. So I'm very happy that and proud to be available and to be called for this occasion. I am a communicator, media is my forte, and the Delhi Metro project, if it had been constructed in the jungle, probably would not have required so much of attention, but in a place like Delhi, the media is present in large numbers, all the VIPs of the city are available, any small thing which happens in the city of Delhi immediately catches attention. To be very honest, you can't hide, you know, what happens when you do urban construction. Everything has to come out. We had an accident once on the Delhi Metro in 2009. And that particular accident, 9 people had died in that. And the contractor, the people wanted us to sack the contractor, sack our engineers. If we had done all that, the project would not have been completed on time. So we issued show cause notices to them. We didn't sack them. We issued charge sheets to the officers, but we didn't sack them. The managing director offered to resign. That was not accepted. And he somehow kept the team together, kept the morale high. And we were able to deliver the project on time. And the media, it taught me a lot of media lessons at that point of time. Because when the accident happened itself, it happened early in the morning at 5 in the morning. Nobody knew the accident will happen. So the media only got a visual of the fallen girder. It was a huge girder which fell down. But DMRC had a very good reputation. So we decided to recover this girder very fast. The recovery operation was well known. So the entire media was covering the recovery operation. And unfortunately, while the recovery operation, we got 4 cranes of 400 tons each to lift this girder. And while the recovery operation was going on, one of the cranes had developed a mechanical fault. It fell onto the other cranes and the whole thing fell onto the press. So the media got very good footage, and more than the accident itself, it was the recovery which gave us a bad name. So it was a lesson for all of us to be, you know, that we learnt in urban construction, in media handling. So a number of things like this in this project, very interesting things have happened, because project delivery on time is not easy. DMRC has been able to achieve it, and all these books, all these things we have tried to encapsulate in books and all, they are available, you know. So these are all very good learning experiences which we had. When the metro project started itself, there were many critics. Many people said it's a white elephant. It will never take off. But today it is serving the city very importantly. Delhi would have been dead but for the Delhi metro. We are expanding in a big, big way. In 6 months, we'll be the fourth largest metro system in the entire world, which is quite, it's becoming a very important lifeline for Delhi. We went for the latest technology in Delhi. People wanted us to go for whatever, you know, the suburban EMUs which exist. And we had a lot of skeptics, though I'm from the railways, we had a lot of skeptics from railways who said, what's wrong with our technology? But we said, we are coming late, so we should go for the latest technology available. And Dr. Kalam himself is a scientist. The MD at that point, and our MD was also a scientist, he was an engineer. And being the latest, today we have trains which can run without drivers. So this is the latest possible in the world. At least on the metro field, we have established a benchmark. Most of our visitors who come to India are from Europe and USA in particular, because those metros are much older than ours. Ours is the latest. They come to see our metro. So this is something which we really showcase very proudly. The metro is highly sustainable, environmentally very friendly. Delhi is one of the most polluted cities, and I'm glad that the metro is expanding in a very big way all over India. So it's a matter of time before the metro expansion, everything starts settling down. So I'd like to thank Srijan for calling me here today and giving me this opportunity to speak to the audience. And I must say, I quite enjoyed Mr. Mulay's talk, very grounded talk which he gave. And it was very happy, very nice to know, sir, that the external affairs is doing so much for Indian citizens. And so, because we always had this impression through movies that the US is very taken up. Anything happens to a US citizen, the entire United States gets together. So it's very, very heartening to know that there's so much going on as far as the Indians are concerned. Thank you. Thank you very much.